We're back, and yeah, regular food shop. Firstly, how much did it cost? That's important.
A lot compared to home.
Did it though, that's the
for
thing.
For what we've got, yeah.
Okay, no, pretty right. So it's $170.
Yeah.
$170,
which is about £150.
No, 110.
No, you're well off.
You're well off.
No.
Trust me.
Okay, where's my phone? I need to.
I've got mine right here.
Okay, convert it. Right. So I said it was about 100 and.
You haven't said 150.
Okay, I'm going to change.
No,
145.
And I'm saying about 120.
Okay.
Yeah.
We'll see who's closer.
Yeah, we'll see who's closer.
Worst.
£129. Closer to mine.
I was going to say that.
So yeah, now this. How long would this last? How long would this normally last? So think about what we got.
We didn't get a lot of meat today.
Yeah. I would say it's going to last about...
4 days.
Yeah.
About 4 days.
3 to 4 days.
Yeah.
That's about 3 to 4 days.
We eat a lot in our household. Yeah. A lot.
Mostly me, but... You know.
Yes.
So let's start. Show you what we got. Okay, we've just got some toilet roll. Nothing interesting there.
Essentials.
Eggs. Mm-hmm. So I've got 12 eggs here. I eat about... 8 to 10, or sometimes 12 eggs a day. Now, don't get that twisted and think, oh yeah, I eat 12 yolks. No, I eat 12 eggs and probably have like one yolk in each meal, you know? So it's mostly egg white, but I do eat, yeah, about 12 eggs a day. For me, eggs are a perfect snack. I have them for breakfast, so, you know, after having my yolks, I have eggs. But then also, late at night, I always have a meal of eggs, you know? And I try and get Shannon to have that because it's a healthy snack. She's always trying to snack in the evening, she's hungry, and she'll...
No, the thing is, I don't like egg. However, I'm partial to a fried egg every now and then. And if I am going to have egg somewhere else, like scrambled egg, it has to be well done. When I say well done, I mean crispy. Like, no wetness, none of that. Okay, I've got gluten-free pasta.
Dead.
That is for me.
Dead. I mean, whole grain. Whole grain pasta.
These are gluten-free as well, though, so, aren't they? They were back home.
I didn't check.
I hope these are gluten-free.
If it was gluten-free, it would say it on it.
No, because the ones at home don't.
But yeah, no, we found these. These are like so convenient. I mean, I don't care if anyone says, oh, you shouldn't microwave food. I don't really care. These are the most convenient things ever. You literally just pop them in a microwave, 90 seconds, you're done.
Easy.
You know, whole grain rice, we can have it with tuna, we can have it with whatever meal that we've cooked, you know, and our vegetables. It's so easy, man. So yeah, we have, I think we've bought 14 in total.
Yeah, we do. You know? Our meals are pretty simple. We have our protein source, whether that's turkey, chicken, fish, tuna, whatever. Then we have our vegetables. And then we'll have either like whole grain rice, if we're having carbs, or my whole grain pasta. So we do get quite a few fresh vegetables. Got to get that in.
I've got here, asparagus. If you guys have seen my other video, my five top healthy greens, you'll know I love asparagus. The other ones were avocado, broccoli, olives, and spinach. Those are my favorite greens. Check out that video if you want to know why and if you want to know the good stuff about them. But yeah, asparagus is just a great, great vegetable. It's got so many good things about it. But check my video, five top healthy greens for gains, if you want to see it, the link's there. I did mention with these peppers that the green one for me is flavorless. Like, I just don't even, if I see a pack of three and it has the green one, I'd rather just leave it.
I'm surprised you picked up the yellow one.
The yellow one has a more subtle flavor, but it still has a flavor. The green one's just dead. Yeah.
All right. Yeah. And I want to ask anyone back home or watching, do you use facial tissues?
There we go.
Because he didn't understand that I was looking for specific facial tissues and not ones to blow my nose.
Me, tissue.
I don't know,
tissue.
Maybe it's because it first started when I was a makeup artist, and when I'm working with people's skin and maybe I'm cleansing it or whatever and you need to dry it off, I'm not going to get a big old towel and start chucking it over someone's face, so I'd use facial tissues. Good.
Oats. What can I say about oats? Hasn't already been said. This is my staple. Even if I'm out at a hotel, whatever, just give me some oats. I don't care if it's got water, if it's having water or milk.
Mm-hmm.
Oats is
but
nice.
You have this good milk.
Yeah, I've got this good milk to have it with. Mm-hmm. It's going to taste great. And then also have it with bananas and cashews. Or if you guys watch my Insta stories, you'll see that I have it with either bananas, cashews, almonds, macadamia nuts, hazelnuts. It just adds to the flavor. Sometimes I'll throw raisins in there as well. Oats and dried fruit. But yeah, oats is just so great, man, as a breakfast. It sustains you for ages. It's got a low glycemic index, so it burns slow and it will just give you energy throughout the morning.
Mm-hmm. I actually make a real tasty homemade granola using oats and the same ingredients that Sim kind of mentioned, like flaked coconut, raisins, cashews. So check it out, guys, if you haven't already. It's really quick, really simple, and the whole family will love it.
You saw the friggin' episode we had trying to find decent baked beans. Now all my British people are gonna be friggin' shocked when I tell you that they did not have Heinz baked beans. They didn't even have a baked beans tin that looked similar to Heinz with just beans and tomato sauce. This was the closest we got, and this vegetarian tangy sauce with brown sugar and spices.
Like, probably gonna taste nice though.
It probably is gonna taste nice, but it's also gonna have a lot of sugar.
Yeah.
Which regular beans doesn't really have. Like beans, I think if I get this correct, beans is one of the things, singular foods that you could actually probably live on. It actually has everything, mm-hmm. everything you need, you know? But yeah, this would not be, I don't think this would be that. So,
yeah, we'll
see. We're looking forward to that. I might even, I don't know, I'll do an Insta story or something and tell you how this tastes. Yeah, mackerel. I always tell you guys we eat a lot of different fish. Tilapia, cod, salmon, and we eat a lot of mackerel.
We love fish.
Healthy, has a lot of good fats. A lot of omega, omega 6 and 3s. So, this was all that we could find. It's the only tin of mackerel that they had. Hopefully it tastes nice. We'll let you know.
We're almost getting to the end. Not without showing you guys the protein though. Now this chicken is natural. No antibiotics and no added hormones. That is a label we have to get used to.
Yeah, you said that like it was normal. This is not normal.
I was trying to.
You said that like it was normal. In the UK, we don't have labels that tell us that there is no antibiotics or no added hormones. We just have chicken. And it doesn't even have to tell you it's natural chicken. It's just chicken.
Just chicken.
You just assume it's chicken.
Yeah.
And you know, so this is quite interesting to actually have all these labels that we see on the foods. So find it. In fact, I'm actually going to do my research. I'm going to do my research and find out why the chicken over here and other meat has to have labels that explains whether it's got hormones in it, antibiotics, etc., and why the UK doesn't.
So I just find it like this even says raised without antibiotics. Well, I should hope not. Like, it's crazy.
We've got two different types of cod here, Alaskan cod and true cod fillet fresh. Honestly speaking, I don't know what the difference is. I just saw cod, and I know that whitefish is tasty and low in fat. And yeah, good for you. And high in protein, so I like my white fish. Like I said, also like tilapia. Back home, we'll buy more sea bream.
Yeah.
And what else?
Sea bass, sea bream. Yeah. Sea bass, a lot of sea bass. Yeah. I mentioned earlier, but we've got turkey burgers, which are banging. We had it yesterday with a whole grain, like, what was it? Like a bun?
Flatbread,
whole grain flatbread.
Normally, like, I'd use a pita bread, but I couldn't really find. You have pita breads here, but they're circular. And I was like, what?
No, but that would have been better for the burger.
Though. It would have, but I was used to, where's my, you know, my regular pita bread?
I suppose so. But anyway, we started having a lot more turkey compared to beef. So instead of beef burgers, we have turkey burgers. Instead of beef mince, we would have turkey mince. Instead of beef jerky, we have turkey jerky.
Got some plum tomatoes here. Shan always makes like a fry up and adds these, and it really tastes nice, you know, so had to get those.
Yes. We've got quite a few of those. I think I've put them on. Oh, no, here we are.
And yeah, we'll probably have red onions in that. We cook with red onions more than we use regular onions. In fact, I don't remember the last time we bought normal onions. There honestly isn't like a health benefit that we're aware of that we buy it for.
Yeah.
Although I'm probably sure there might be. We buy it because it tastes nicer. Red onions are sweet and they're really nice.
We are almost... I think the fish leaked.
Yeah, I can smell it.
Oh my God, and you didn't tell.
Okay, almost done. I've got to show you the goodies, man.
I was about to say, it's not all boring. We have some treats. Oh yeah, some real treats. Oh.
Oh, yeah, British flavor. Yeah.
Okay, hold on. We need a vote. Guys, which is better?
Yeah,
okay.
Vote in the comments, yeah? Cherry Pop-Tarts or whatever that is.
Or
yeah?
S'mores Pop-Tarts.
Now, I'm going to show you something that's going to make you, like, just laugh. Shan, what does that taste like?
I am visioning some marshmallow.
No. But what does it taste like?
Do you know what? I haven't tried it before.
You haven't tried it?
Have you tried this one?
Of course I've tried cherry.
Have you tried cherry pop-tart?
Yes, I have.
You haven't had these
Yes,
before.
I have.
No, you're lying.
Yes, I'm not lying.
I've had
cherry pop-tarts, guys.
Anyway,
I'm not going to argue about whether I've had cherry pop-tarts. Like, come on, man. But she's never tasted this, and she picked it up in the place of my, what was it, brown sugar?
Cinnamon. Who wants a cinnamon pop-tart?
Perfect. But yeah, these are our treats.
Hold on. There's more.
No, don't show them all our treats, all our goodies. I'm joking now, look at this. This is for movie nights.
See guys, we are normal.
And we have loads of flavors of ice cream here as well. I mean, we did go a bit extra with the healthy stuff and got like low, what is it? It's very low fat, low everything, low sugar. 240 calories, etc. So we did go, you know, healthy with the ice cream, but we
got this
still.
One as well, haven't tried it yet, but it's 94% fat free. So what we're gonna do is we've got our little cinema bags. We're gonna mix this with some naughty ones. We don't eat the whole bag.
Yeah,
see,
that was my idea.
Moderation.
That was my idea. So eat the healthy stuff, and then every now and then you get a little treat because you're gonna have one of these pecan ones
in.
Or one of these cashew ones. So you know, a little bit of moderation.
Yeah.
And then we got our regular cashews. We eat a lot of nuts.
Love
as
them.
A snack. You eat too many. Guys, check what I had to do. So, Shan goes OTT with the nuts, so I have to hide them. Little Shan cannot reach up here. So, I'm keeping them up there.
Like, I actually can't reach up
Good.
There.
Good.
So, he hides the cashews, pushes them right to the back.
And that's about it.
That's it.
I'm not interested in shaving cream, but
no.
That's the last thing.
Or my mentor, something else we have different. I'm mint, he's fruit.
Yeah. I like the flavors, like strawberries and all that stuff. So.
That's about it, guys.
So, what's coming next? We're gonna cook. We're gonna cook for you.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. Should I cook with Shan or should I cook on my own? Write in the comments if you want to see me cooking. If you want to see us cooking? You know.
Can I just say something to you guys? I cook dinner every day.
What's your point?
Me. You want me to cook?
But you said that like I don't cook.
Sometimes.
Yeah. So.
But I cook every day.
Yeah.
So that means put me. You want to see me cook?
Let us know who you want to see. You want to see me cook, or if you want to see us cook? Let me know.
All right.